questions.
No, but
it's in SACWA. You go to the SACWA document, no, it's in there.
I know SACWA very well.
Okay,
I'm
okay.
SACWA's boss, okay. I would know more than them.
Go to SACWA, go to any qualification.
I know.
It's got international compatibility.
No,
so what are you saying that we can't compare?
It's not the issue of comparison. A private provider of education and training must be registered with the state.
Yes, that's what we mean.
Article 29.3.
Yes.
So you're a private provider of education and training for these qualifications.
Yes.
You are not registered with the state.
No, we were going through CETA, number one.
No,
yes, no, let me explain.
For these international ones as
the
well.
The new qualifications,
yeah.
Every qualification that we offer gets regulated and every certificate goes to SACWA for evaluation. SACWA evaluates the international comparability with our qualifications.
Except
and
they
put
you
it on a certain
except
level.
That you are not registered with the state. The Constitution makes it a requirement that private providers, it's in the Constitution.
Yeah, but reading.
You expect me to walk with thick sets of legislation throughout the city.
Huh?
No, Article 29, just
but
Google it.
So that Article 29?
Article 29.3 of the Constitution states that a private provider of education and training must be registered with the state. There are two sets of legislation, the Higher Education Act, the CETA, the CET Act.
Yeah,
and
CETAs.
Then we've got the CETAs and QCTO skills provider.
Are we falling under the CETAs?
Now, you're following, okay, fine, I don't argue.
Yes.
Right.